Ivermectin is the mainstay of treatment for filarial diseases, and its administration to entire populations has the potential to eradicate lymphatic filariasis and onchocerciasis in areas of endemic disease. Although generally safe, ivermectin has been associated with post-treatment encephalopathy, which can be fatal in the context of significant loa loa infection with high microfilarial density. To improve the safety of mass ivermectin administration, researchers developed the loascope, which provides a fast and cheap way to quantify loa loa in peripheral blood. Using the loascope, investigators studied the feasibility of a test and not treat strategy, giving ivermectin only to patients without loa loa or with a lower loa loa microfilarial density load. The study was conducted in 92 villages in 6 health areas in the Okola district of Cameroon, where ivermectin distribution was halted in 1999 owing to concern about loa loa associated encephalopathy and deaths. 22,842 persons 5 years of age or older were invited to participate, and 16,259 agreed to be tested, of whom 96% were given ivermectin. Of the excluded participants, 2.1% had higher loa loa microfilarial density loads, greater than 20,000. 1.4% had poor health, and 1% were pregnant or breastfeeding. All non-pregnant participants received albendazole for intestinal decontamination. Daily active surveillance for post-treatment adverse events was conducted for 6 days, and 2,818 events were recorded. There were 3 occurrences of grade 3 adverse events, and no hospitalizations or deaths. All adverse events resolved within 1 week, without treatment or with basic supportive care. The authors conclude that the loascope-based test and not treat strategy is a potentially practical approach for large-scale ivermectin treatment for lymphatic filariasis and onchocerciasis in loa loa endemic areas. Full trial results are available at nejm.org.